Hey, this is Erik with Landscape Garden Centers. We're going to talk about roses, the different kinds of roses, how to take care of them, and some of my favorites and some of my least favorite. Talking about hybrid tea roses, this would fall under the category of least favorite. This is what everybody used to see at grandma's house when you go over and go over to their house. It comes up on a rootstock, and they'll have the different flowers. And these roses were bred and created to be long, single flowers that are used in floral arrangements, cut flowers. And the cut flowers would last for a long time, very, very fragrant. Most of the hybrid teas are probably the most fragrant of all flowers that you can get out there right now. One of the things about them is that they get kind of finicky. Finicky as far as their foliage. You can't water them on top of the foliage. You have to watch out, make sure they're in full sun. They can get different funguses and diseases, which becomes kind of a pain in the butt, because then you have to be always maintaining and putting on different chemicals on them. So there's just a lot more maintenance with them. Some people like them. I know grandma used to like them, but it didn't make my top 10 list. So we'll go over and talk about the shrub roses. Shrub roses, they're the hardiest of all the roses that are out there. People are always asking, they're always wondering, hey, what can I get that blooms all the time? Perennials do not bloom all the time. Annuals are about the only thing that do bloom. And then you get into roses, and roses bloom all the time. And that's the great thing about roses, especially shrub roses and the different types of shrub roses, is that they have so many flowers. They're probably not as fragrant, but they're constantly flowering. They're really easy to take care of. The foliage on them, they've been hybridized in order to have the strongest foliage to be able to withstand diseases, those types of issues that shrub roses will have. The colors are probably not as grandiose as if when you get into a hybrid tea. There's a few yellows, some whites, some light pinks as I'm looking around here, but mostly that's the color range that we're going to be in. So when it comes to roses, you choose the different colors that you're gonna have. There's a lot of different textures and stuff like that. But basically, they're gonna be a really good plant for the landscape. They love the sun. The more sun, the more flowers. And basically, they're really, really simple. Again, this is Erik with Landscape Garden Centers. Keep it growing.